Well, welcome back to my Let's Play of Infinite Space, where hopefully we'll get a bit closer to the end this time. Well, we always are, but only a couple more chapters to go, thankfully. Oops, tapped the mic again. Speed up. Ah, can I have your autograph? It's Lord Roth! It's Lord Roth! What the? The excited screams and cries of a mob of frantic young women assault Yuri-Honey's ears as they step off their ship. Just as Yuri expected, he finds that it's Lord Roth once again, surrounded by a mob of attractive, albeit hysterical, women. Oh, Yuri, did you just get back? Lord Roth, I didn't know you were supposed to be back already. Don't worry, I left adequate forces to deal with Libertas' fleet. Besides, they don't seem to have the will to fight. Both sides are just staring each other down right now. It's ever so boring. One who has been instantly watching the two men speak timidly interrupts. Excuse me, you wouldn't happen to be the captain known as Yuri, would you? I am, but... Oh my god! The young woman once again bursts into a chorus of excited screams, cries, and giggles. It really is Yuri. Oh, he's so dreamy. Please, can I have your autograph? Shake my hand! Oh, please, please, shake my hand! Hey, ow, let go! Stop pulling like that! looks like you've gotten a bit famous too, Yuri. Go on now, sign a few autographs for the nice ladies. I'm not really into stuff like that, besides... Yuri looks over at his sister with a troubled, if not vaguely guilty look on his face. What? Oh... No, it's just, even if you said it was alright, you know, I wouldn't say it's okay, so. Well, Kira does not show it outwardly. Yuri can tell that she is steaming mad by the tone of her reply. In response, Yuri makes a hasty escape, leaving Lord Roth and the screaming mob behind. Fangirl is scary enough to scare away even a dangerous captain. Your officers are already see at headquarters on Renton, and have been waiting for Yuri and company to arrive. Among the officers, Yuri notices Norbert Weimer from the Interplanetary Assembly. Well done, Yuri. Lieutenant Baron has updated me on your recent efforts. Your skill in forcing Enemazo's surrender with minimal loss of friendly forces is quite impressive. Looks like your operation went well, too. Indeed it has. Zanato has promised to sever ties with Libertas and remain neutral. Now Libertas no longer has any significant allies among the nations of the large Magellan Cloud. What's the situation like in the Galactic Federation? Allow me to explain. With the surrender of Enmazo and Zanato... sorry, a bit tired still. I'm doing this at like 5 in the morning. The balance of power has overwhelmingly shifted in our favor. As a result, many nations that have been uncommitted have finally begun voicing their support for the Interplanetary Assembly, and more are coming around each day. Now it's time to seize this opportunity and do what the Federation... darn, I skipped that. Allow the nations of the Interplanetary Assembly to work towards formulating a response against the Logavius threat. Assembly Member Weimer, what do you think your chances are of bringing about a political solution? Frankly speaking, zero. After all, military force has always been a louder voice than cries for peace. Then there's orders, a veritable hotbed of hardliners. The hothead. They still have more than enough military might to make things difficult. If push comes to shove, they could very well dispatch a fleet over Mare, we get to pressure the assembly. So you're saying you just have to smash Order's fleet to bits, is that it? That shouldn't be all that difficult. In theory, yes, but it's far more complex than you might think. You see, once you attack Order's, you're basically attacking Libertas itself. And I need not remind you that Libertas controls 1/3 of the military vessels under Federation command. Yes, but that's assuming they can live up to their potential. What do you mean? Neil, would you do the honors? Okay, allow me to explain. Now, this is only based on my impression from when our royal fleet confronted the Libertasian fleet in the Hewars sector, but it appears as if some elements within Libertas itself are taking a wait and wash away attitude to the events we've set in motion. I say this because during the 2 month period we faced their fleet, the only one on the offensive twice. Even that only amounted to a small skirmish and they quickly withdrew. That's why I think it's premature to assume they all sympathize with and are ready to die for orders. Yes, I see what you mean. The official policy has been decided upon. We are to invade Libertas and crush the Order's fleet. Commotion arises from among the officers gathered in the war room as the scene of this moment hits them. The first time in the nearly 500 years that Libertas has dominated the Federation, the winds of change are in the air. That may be our only choice. Indeed, but this battle must not ignite into an all-out war with Libertas. Something I want, I regret having to ask you to bear such a burden, but we're counting on you for damage control. I know. I will stake my honor as a career politician on extinguishing the flames of war that will no doubt arise. Excellent. Now it's time for our top military officials to formulate a strategic plan for achieving our goal. I'd like the rest of you to stand by off plant until further notice. You are dismissed. Ends the meeting, and immediately his officers get up and leave with excited looks on their faces. Yuri, it's turning out just like you said. What do you mean? You know, the unification of the large Magellan cloud. Let's get together over drinks sometime. Meet over at the Royal Fleet's headquarters. Sure, sounds good. Let's see. Okay. Maybe I can still do that. And ends on our side now, so Libertas should be a cinch. I wish it were that easy. Unfortunately, Zenate got away. And our opponent is still stronger than our side, at least militarily. That sucks, and here I was thinking that the worst was already over. Well, too late now. No, I'm pretty sure we got her. Yuri, we have a ship approaching us from behind. Is it a Rengalic ship? No, it's... let's see. There you are, Yuri. Selena. Seems you've made quite a name for yourself around here, kid. Lucky for me, that made it a lot easier to find you. Selena, I'm so glad you were able to make it here okay. Yeah, but I had some pretty close calls along the way. If I'd waited any longer, I might never have been able to get through that damned gate. Why is that? It's those Logavians. Their ships are massing near the gate over on the small Magellan cloud side. There are already several tens of thousands there when I blasted my way through. That's not good. So then you're saying, Lugavios' invasion of the large moon of the cloud is drawing near. Oh, and, what? Selena shows a moment of hesitation, but when she sees Yuri's powerful gaze transfixed on her, she quickly recovers. Looks like Sio's leading the fleet, and two ace commanders have been called in from their homeworld. The first is Ursula Macklin. Word is she's the daughter of Admiral Galvin Macklin, commander of the Macklin fleet directly under the Emperor's control. And the second commander is none other than our old pal, Neil Ehrman. What? Ehrman? He's still alive? I'm afraid so. He's demoted after his huge blunder 10 years ago, but they brought him back after Desmond died. I came to the large Magellan cloud to warn you, Yuri. Logavius is playing with a stacked deck. Each of those people is a serious threat. Thanks. I appreciate you going out of your way to deliver that information. No problem. I hope we meet again sometime. Please wait. Selena, if you'd like, we'd sure love for you to join. I'm a pirate. I always have been. I always will be. Remember, Yuri, never lose your cool. A level ahead is the key to survival. Got it. Yuri, isn't Ermin that... Right. He led the invasion of the small angelic cloud, and he's the one responsible for Nia's death. Yuri's jaw is clenched tight. The faint sounds of his teeth grinding together can still be heard. All Yuri can do is stare anxiously at Yuri, who's obviously struggling with some powerful emotions. Oh yeah, we can do something here too. Boom. As soon as Yuri and company arrive at the Space Armored Fleet headquarters, they are quickly ushered into Dietrich Schneider's office. Ah, Captain, you've got perfect timing. I wanted to hear your opinion on something. What's that? It's about Enzyman, so... Actually, Tidor Vasani, Prince of Enemazo, is standing behind Yuri and seems startled when he hears mention of his country. It's not clear whether Dietrich Schneider even notices this as he continues to speak in a matter-of-fact manner. Enzima has offered to dispatch Prince Adolfo to serve in our military forces as proof of their alliance with us. He would hold the rank of visiting officer. What you're meaning is that he will be your hostage. What? You could look at it that way, I suppose. Should we accept their proposal? We'll go this way, because we can't recruit him even if we take this option. Because we recruited his brother, so... You won't be needing any hostages. Are you sure about that? There's no need to worry. I've heard that Tiora 23rd is a man lacking both decisiveness and ambition. You'd not be capable of duplicity, and that includes betraying his render to Renegold. You do have a point, considering Tiora 235th's character. Our report the situation to my superiors. Sails deeply, clearly relieved by Dietrich Sizer's response. Improvements to my flagship, huh? Upon entering the Royal Fleet headquarters, Neil Becker immediately ushers Yuri into a quiet room. Upon closer inspection, it appears to be Lord Ross' private quarters. I'm glad you can make it. You know, give me that bottle of Burkmeister, would you? A little early to start drinking, isn't it, Lord Roth? Sobering times call for drastic measures, Neil, and I think libations are in order. Ah, whatever. Whatever you say. I'll have mine on the rocks, Yuri. Me too, thanks. Coming right up. Nah, Neil quickly puts a couple of glasses and a bucket of ice on a tray and brings it over to the table. Then, with what appears to be a slightly sarcastic bow, she leaves the room. You're surprised to see that Neil has also managed to whip up sandwiches stacked high with pan molo meat. Wow, she's a great hostess. Who is? Neil, Adjects don't usually do stuff like this, you know? Is there something you're not telling me about, you two? Oh, don't be silly, she's my adjunct, nothing more. Oh, I see. Come on, I mean, sure, we've known each other since the Officer Academy and all, but we're just good friends and co-workers. Okay, if you say so. Well, I get the impression you don't believe me. Anyway, what about you? Neil's told me about you and that girl, Kira. Huh? She's not just any old crew member now, is she? Right, she's not any old crew member. She's my sister. So you say, but does anyone actually believe that? I don't care what anyone thinks. She's my sister and a member of my crew, that's all. As you so succinctly say, okay if you say so. Roth grins as he imitates Yuri's manner of speech. Yuri responds with an annoyed look and takes a swig of his drink. You know, I've been meaning to ask you for some time now. Ask me what? Just how serious are you about all of this? You mean about uniting the LMC? Right, things seem to be heading in that direction. Is that really what you had planned? It was more of a last resort than a plan. Uniting the large Ninja Cloud was the only option left for opposing Lugivian domination, yes, but you're not even from the large Ninja Cloud. What reason could you possibly have for wanting to defend our galaxy? Oh, I have reason enough, alright. You do? Yeah, I'm a Zero G-Dog through and through. There's no way I could ever live under Lugivia's iron thumb. I mean, they don't even let their spacefarers really navigate the stars. I don't care who it is. If someone tries to take away my freedom to roam the cosmos, I'm going to bite back hard. That's what any decent, self-respecting Zero G-Dog would do. Lorath listens intently to Yuri's explanation, an unreadable look in his eyes. Lorath eventually speaks, he does slowly, watching Yuri carefully. I'm sorry, but that doesn't sit with me. Why not? I don't believe it's your real motive. Huh? I just like being around the bush, so I'll just come out and say it. I believe you want to use the Large Ninja Cloud to get your revenge against the Lugivians. Do you think I'm out for revenge? That's right. Neil heard all about it from one of your old friends. That incident concerning the woman named Neo Lauchan. Well, are you going to look me in the eye and say you're not using the Large Ninja Cloud to sell an old score? Frankly, I don't know. That's about all I can say. You don't know? There's definitely a part of me that wants to get revenge for what happened to Nia, it's true. But I also want to protect this galaxy. I would never lie about something as important as that. So which is it? Like I said before, I really didn't know for sure myself. Don't know. I see. So you don't even know yourself. I actually know what you mean about not knowing, if that makes any sense. After all, is there anyone out there who truly knows exactly why they feel the way they do? No, there's no need to say another word. Let's drink some more, a lot more, in fact. Bottoms up. Lorath quickly clinks his glass against one Yuri's hand. The two proceed to drain what's left in their glasses with synchronized gulps. This is Aeronaut's Royal Fleet Headquarters. Back at the war room, Lorath is working at a terminal, while at his side, Neil Becker is sorting through documents. Name like the Royal Fleet, I thought you guys would never leave the King's side. Well, we do serve directly under the King, and we follow his every order, whatever it may be. I suppose you could say we're more like the old man's errand boys. Hartwig, have a little more respect when you talk about his majesty. Oh, what's the big deal, Neil? He's not here, is he? Anyway, our country is better attacking than defending. That's why the Royal Fleet is given the freedom to go out on missions far from the King's side whenever it's necessary. So then you have the ability to execute whatever orders you're given? That's what makes you the Royal Fleet? Exactly. I envy you, Yuri. Where'd that come from all of a sudden? I'm just a little jealous of the freedom you Zero G-Dogs have compared to us military types. I mean, for one thing, your female crew members can dress however they please. It's quite a feast for the eyes, I must say. Maybe you're right. It doesn't hurt to have something nice to look at when you're on a long voyage. Exactly. Well, I'm always stuck on military ships with female officers in their bland, ugly uniforms. You're going to get an earful from me later, Hartwig. Does the term sexual harassment not mean anything to you? Uh-oh. Really, Yuri? Lorath told me that you graduated second in your class at the academy. Yes, I did. then you're obviously qualified for something higher than adjunct. Don't you want to work your way up the ranks? Work my way up? No, thank you. What's the deal? Don't you got no ambition? It's not that, it's just if I work my way up, I'll eventually outrank Lord Roth. A lazy bum like that as a subordinate would make my life even more miserable than it is now. Okay, whatever you say. Now I need to wander around a bit. Oops. I'll go there and... Yuri just received a message from Vice Admiral Saint. He has details on the next operation, so he wants us to return to headquarters back on Renton. Okay. Finally, a decisive battle with Libertas. It's gonna be a big one, alright. Not necessarily, not all Libertas. It's that cough again. Are you sure you're alright? You look pale, Master Jin. Oh, don't worry. You worry about me. I'll be fine. Ugh. At least I'm not alone having coughing fits. Yuri, do you have a moment? Lieutenant Arkov comes up behind Yuri as he's preparing to dock at the spaceport and starts talking in a hushed tones. It's Jen. He's gotten much worse. He has? Yeah, our medical staff examined him, but he's already grown extremely weak. He's sleeping in the sick bay right now. Will he recover? I don't know. It's not that he's particularly sick, it's more of an age-related thing. I don't even know if he'll ever be able to get up out of bed again. I'm trying to convince him to check into an off-ship hospital, but he won't hear of it. What do you think we should do, Yuri? Let him do whatever he wants. Are you sure that's a good idea? Men like him would rather draw their last breaths on the battlefield, even if they can't stand on their own. If you say so. You know, you men can be such stubborn idiots sometimes. In a huff, Titania leaves to return to her post. Officer Ringall's military have already gathered, here in full force at their headquarters on Renton. But not one of them utters so much as a word as they wait for Lieutenant Ludiger Sank to begin speaking. Alright, I'm going to provide you with an overview of our military offensive against Libertas and orders. Taking out orders will be a key because they form the core of the hardliners within Libertas and the Federation itself. Remember, striking orders hard without allowing the conflict to expand is our main objective here. Well, it's most likely going to take place in high... or sector near the Ellison Star System. Last sector provides high navigational safety and can accommodate numerous fleets, which makes it a perfect battlefield. The enemy no doubt sees that too and will choose to engage us there. We'll deploy 5 ships from the Royal Fleet and 120 from the Space Armored Fleet. They'll be supported by 15 ships from the Dragoon Fleet and 30 from the Heavy Artillery Fleet. We also plan to rendezvous with fleets from our allies in Seal and the recently defeated Enzimanzo. Motion spreads throughout the war room in response to Lugner Sank's plan, so we'll commit the vast majority of our military to the strike force. Home planet defenses will be left at worst and bare minimum. This is the only way to put us on equal footing, I'm afraid. Considering that this is a battle for the very future of the Galactic Federation, I wish we had more to spare. Yes, but... simply put, if we lose this battle, we'll be swiftly brought under Libertasian control anyway. There won't be any home planets to defend. There's one more important role to be filled. Will you help us once more, Yuri? What did you have in mind? As I mentioned, we are going to attempt to engage their main force. That will allow you to break through the enemy line from another direction and strike Order's home base. Interesting. Wait just a minute, that's far too risky, even bordering on suicide. Dr. Steiner abruptly rises to his feet and blurts out his concern, interrupting Yuri before he can respond. But Lester's saying continues without batting an eye, despite the lieutenant's criticisms. The enemy fleet must be hit hard. As long as Libertas stands behind orders, there will be no avoiding a protracted war. The fact that Lucavius may mount an invasion at any time dictates we must bring hostilities to a swift end. But don't worry, Lieutenant. Missions like these are second nature to me. Captain. So where's that stinking orders base anyhow? Arntalan service hasn't been able to pinpoint its location yet. All I know so far is that it's a space fortress known as Tauros. In other words, you're telling us to find ourselves, aren't you? I'm afraid so. Don't we got anything better to do than go on some wild goose chase? Lay off the guy, Franny, don't you see? He's giving us the tough mission, because we're just that good. Toro's right, at least about taking on tough missions. You can count on us, Vice Admiral. Sorry to put you in this position, Captain. Alright, this concludes our strategy meeting. Access to the official orders will be provided in 27 hours. Till then, all ships are remain on high alert. You'll receive your formation charts along with your orders, at which point we'll begin shipping out to the staging point. I think that'll do for now, because next part we're gonna have to go to war! Yay! So yeah, see you next time.